Truth in New Jersey Politics, okay? Rich Zunt reporting. I'm down here with Gail Kesselman.
Hello.
Hi.
And
Alexandra.
Last name?
Markovskaya.
Oh, I love that last name.
Okay.
And we're out in front of Steve Rothman's Hackensack office. And why are we here, Gail?
We're here because we want to express our opposition to granting amnesty to illegal immigrants. There's going to be a big march in Washington this weekend. They're starting them marching on Sunday, and then Monday there's going to be lobbying efforts from supporters of illegal immigration who are requesting, among other things, so-called comprehensive immigration reform. Basically, that includes amnesty for illegal immigrants. We are against that, and we just came out of Congressman Rothman's office where we expressed our opposition. There have been many amnesties over the years. The one that most people are familiar with is the one under President Reagan. We had 3 million illegal immigrants at that time. President Reagan agreed to amnesty, and I think he expressed some reluctance, but he said if this solves the problem, then it'll be worth it. We had 3 million immigrants, illegal immigrants at that time, and now all these years after that, we now have 12 to 20 million illegal immigrants. These amnesties don't work. If we have amnesty now, you know how long it'll be before we have more illegal immigrants? It'll just take less than a day. We'll have more illegal immigrants. It doesn't work. What does work is attrition through enforcement, and there's two specific measures that can be taken. First of all, there is E-Verify, which enables employers to check with a national computer database to see if a prospective employee has a valid Social Security number. And that way they can be sure that a person that they're hired is a legal resident or U.S. citizen. The other thing that's available is Program 287G, which allows local law enforcement to cooperate with the federal government to enforce immigration law. There's only a certain number of federal agents that there's only, I think, 6,000 of them. They can't be in every city at every time. And Program 287G allows local police to play a role in enforcing immigration law. And then, of course, the third measure is to secure the southern border, not with the virtual fence, which turned out to be a waste of money. But there are more effective ways to secure the border. And with those measures, we can solve the problem of illegal immigration. And I also want to point out, we have now an unemployment rate of close to 10%. We have about 12 to 15 million unemployed Americans, possibly a little higher. And we have 12 to 20 million illegal immigrants. If the illegal immigrants were to return to their home countries, that would open up 12 to 20 million jobs for, or it would open up jobs for 12 to 20 million American citizens, and it would help to solve the unemployment problem.
Gail, is there a website that our viewers can go to and find out more information on this Amnesty Act?
Yeah, my organization is New Jersey Citizens for Immigration Control, and the website is www.njcic.com. That's N as in Nancy, J, C-I-C.com. And you can sign up to get email alerts. We tend to focus on New Jersey issues specifically, but I work very actively with national organizations such as FAIR, Federation for American Immigration Reform, ALIPAC, which is Americans for Legal Immigration PAC, and Numbers USA, and various other anti-illegal immigration groups. So it's a good way, if you want to sign up for my email alerts, it's a good way to keep informed about what's going on with the illegal immigration situation. I think, one of the most important crises facing our country, actually. And we have a few crises facing our country, but that's one of them.
Alexandra, okay, that's a great accent you have, but I don't think it's from Bayonne, all right? Could you tell the folks where you came from? And I know you're legally here, and how you feel about illegals all of a sudden just being granted amnesty?
I came to America in 1994, which is 16 years ago, and I'm American citizen, and I fall in love with this country, and I'm a big American patriot. My feeling is, first of all, we need to secure our border. And what I want to remind you, everybody, that we have a healthcare takeover going on now. And if you're going to have amnesty right after the healthcare bill, you have to remember this is all illegal immigrants going to be part of our healthcare. And the bill is going to be huge. It's one of the reasons why I'm opposing amnesty.
Fair enough. Anything else you folks would like to say?
I would just sum up to say, according to Mike Cutler, is a friend of mine who's involved in the anti-illegal immigration, he likes to say, a country without borders is like a house without walls. And that's the long and the short of it.
Okay, thank you both very much. And remember, get a hold of your congressmen, get a hold of your senators, and let's stop this amnesty.
Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down. Hey, baby, there ain't no easy way out. Hey, I will stand my ground, and I won't back down.
Who the hell do you think you are? Move a little bit to the right.